Now we know already that there is a hard cover around our life. What is that cover? It's called ignorance. There's a hard cover around our life. It's called ignorance, avidya. Because of this ignorance, always there is a distortion perception in our life. Because of this color. What is the meaning of distortion perception?
We don't see it in the real way.
Yeah, that's meaning sanya vipallasa. The Supreme Buddha explained this as sanya vipallasa. Because of our life has been covered with that hard cover, hard shell, ignorance, always we perceive the world not in the real way. Because of this reason, always we are living our life something in very dark condition. That is why the Supreme Buddha explained, always suffering is with our life. This suffering is not limited for this just life, but the suffering is, it is a continuous process. That's called the cycle of birth and death, the long journey of samsara. Okay, now can you understand the basically what is the reason for this suffering? That hard shell, that's called ignorance. Okay, what is the result of this ignorance? We haven't the ability to perceive the world in
the true perspective way.
Yes, the true perspective way. That means in the real way, as it is. Always we perceive the world, Supreme Buddha said, in the distortion position, in the distortion perception. That means in the world, when we perceive the world, the things that are impermanent things, impermanent, we perceive as permanent. Impermanent thing as permanent. And the unpleasant things as pleasant. And the things with the foulness we perceive as beautiful and attractive things. And the things with non-self we perceive as self. That's called sanya vipallasa. In the sanya vipallasa sutta in Anguttara Nikaya, our great teacher explained in this case, because of this distortion perception, we can't understand our life in the correct way. There is a real darkness in our life. Because of this darkness, we failed to understand the life in this long journey of samsara. So this life is very rare. This human life is very rare. Because of what? In this life, we have the opportunity to understand this, about this shell. Understanding this shell, about the condition of this shell, if he is a wise person, he has the opportunity to break this shell. The breaking of this shell, what is the result? He or she will be able to perceive the world as it is. That's called true knowledge. The totally breakdown of the shell is called true knowledge. That's called vidya. So the thing we have to understand is, always we are in that shell. Living in that shell, we associate the other outer conditions. Understand? So, that's called the distortion of the perception. Without the help of this Tathagata, no one can break this shell. The result of this unknown of the Four Noble Truths, again and again, he will be reborn in the animal world, in the gold world, in the hell, within the gods and the humans. With this birth, the result is only two things. What are those? Aging and death. So, understanding this, the nature of the birth, what is the nature of the birth? Only result is aging and death. Coming to this special point that within this birth, the only results are aging and death, the wise person, the wise man or woman have the chance to overcome this, all the sufferings. That is why all this human life is very, very, very rare and with so many opportunities to break that shell. Is it so? So, basically in the Supreme Buddha's Dhamma, we have to understand that in this our life, there isn't a self. Or there is a thing that we can obtain like this. Or this should be like this. And this should not be like this within our life. We have to understand that there isn't a condition like that. That's called self. How to understand that there isn't a self here in this our life? What is the way? We have to understand what? Yes, through what? Through the dependent arising. That's called paticca-samuppada. Understanding the real nature of the life, that's called dependent arising. One can understand that there is nothing about the self here. There is a cause and effect in our life. So, if one can see the cause, what is the result? The effect also sees. That is the basic theory. So, in our level, in this first step of the wisdom, this all the Supreme Buddha's knowledge is called the wisdom. So, that is why this Dhamma is for the wise, not for the unwise. So, what is the basic tool to understand this process? What is the basic tool in our life? Yes, that means wisdom. Wisdom is the basic tool to be developed in our life. Developing the wisdom, we have to do four things. How many things? Four things. The first one is, we have to realize one thing. Second one is, we have to eradicate one thing. Third one is, we have to attain one thing. Fourth one is, we have to follow one thing. What are those?
The Four Noble Truths.
The first truth should be realized, or should be understood. The second truth should be eradicated. The third truth should be attaining, that means experience. The fourth should be followed, that means should be developed. That's called understanding the Four Noble Truths. That is the basic thing, that is the basic theme of the arising of the Supreme Buddha, to help to understand the Four Noble Truths. That unknown of the Four Noble Truths is called ignorance. So what is the meaning of ignorance? Unknown of the Four Noble Truths. So what is the reason for that hard shell? Same. Not understanding about the Four Noble Truths. The vijja means, the true knowledge means understanding the Four Noble Truths. Now, is it clear? Understanding, only understanding the Four Noble Truths, one can break that shell. So, now suffering is with that shell. Now, without the shell, what is there? The suffering is with the shell. And without the shell, what is there? Real happiness. So what is the way to achieve the real happiness? Break the shell. After, with the breaking of that shell, step by step, through that shell, the real happiness is coming to that life. That is the Supreme Buddha's Dhamma. So if one can, if one has the ability to understand this truth fully, what is the result? The real happiness, the total happiness, the ultimate deliverance is with that life. So in this life, as possible as we can, we must try to break that shell. To break that shell, we have to understand about that Four Noble Truths. In this case, this understanding of the Four Noble Truths, the basic path to enter of this knowledge of Four Noble Truths is understanding the dependent arising. We talked about it. In this first truth, what is the first truth? Suffering. So think about this. Supreme Buddha, great teacher, explains that the birth is suffering, aging is suffering, illness is suffering. Then, yes, so on. And the at the end of this explanation, what is there? When summarizing the dukkha, suffering, the five aggregates of clinging is suffering. So that is the suffering. So what should we have to do to be done with that suffering? We have to realize, we have to understand that suffering. So that means we haven't a real knowledge about the suffering. What's the name of it? The suffering is the thing we have to understand. So what's the meaning of that? We haven't a real understanding about the suffering. The suffering is always with our life. Aging, illness, death, sorrow, lamentation and grief and all the things. But we have the clear knowledge about this suffering. Because of this unknown of this suffering, the result is again and again we have to pay for the suffering. Okay, now is it clear? The reason to understand the suffering is we have a clear understanding about the suffering. This is a noble truth. So the second one is the cause for the origination of the suffering. Okay. In the Supreme Buddha's Dhamma, what is the origination for the suffering? Craving. Simply it's craving. So now let's take that five aggregates of eating. That means in brief, the five aggregates are five aggregates of clinging are the suffering. So Supreme Buddha explains that if someone understands these five aggregates of clinging, he has the chance to understand the whole mass of suffering. Understand? With the understanding of the five aggregates of clinging as it is, he or she has the opportunity to understand the whole mass of suffering. That means understanding the five aggregates of clinging, he will be able to understand the aging, birth, aging, illness, death, and sorrow, lamentation, grief, pain, and this and all the sufferings, all the conditions of suffering. Can you understand it? So the meaning of the unknown of these five aggregates of clinging is meaning it. We haven't the understanding about birth. We haven't the understanding about the age. We haven't the understanding about the illness. We haven't the understanding about the death. And so on. So, in the second truth, the origination for the suffering is, as Supreme Buddha said, the craving. What is the meaning of it? We have the craving. We have the desire to what? To that five aggregates of clinging. Understand? The cause for the suffering, the origination of the suffering is craving. So suffering is the five aggregates of clinging. So this craving is with what? With that five aggregates of clinging. So what is the meaning of that? We have the craving. We have the desire to what? To birth. To aging. We have the desire. We have the craving for illness. We have the craving for the death. We have the craving for the sorrow, lamentation, pain, grief, and all the sufferings. We have the craving for the suffering. That's called avijja, ignorance. Can you understand? What's the reason for our this mass suffering? Ignorance. What's the ignorance? Yes, we have the craving for the suffering. We have the desire for the suffering. So, attaching to the suffering, grasping to the suffering, we wish. Yes, we wish a life without suffering. That's called ignorance. All these distortion perception is because of that shell. Now can you understand the danger of that shell? Being with the desire and the craving for the suffering, again we hope a life without suffering. this thing is, we have the opportunity to understand this thing only in the Supreme Buddha session. Now, is it clear the second truth? Yes, it is the craving for the five aggregates of feeling. That means that now five aggregates of feeling is the suffering, no? So we have the suffering for the suffering. We have the desire for the suffering. The third truth is the cessation of the suffering. That means the if the craving is the origination of the suffering, what is the cessation? The remainless craving. So, what is this remainless craving contacting? With what? With that five aggregates of clinging. So craving is with the five aggregates of clinging. That is why all the suffering is there. So the cessation is what? The remains of that craving from what? From the five aggregates of clinging. That is the cessation of suffering. To understand this, to cease this suffering, to cease this cause of the suffering, to abandon the desire for the suffering, to abandon the desire, to abandon the craving with the five aggregates of clinging, there is a path to be followed. That's called Noble Eightfold Path. That is the fourth truth. So the meaning of the Noble Eightfold Path is the what the meaning? There is a path to escape from the aging. There's a path to escape from the illness. A path to escape from the death, sorrow and other bodily sufferings. So so the meaning of that we are following the Four Noble Truths is what? We are following the way to escape from the aging, to escape from the illness, escape from the death. What is the reason? We have to follow our special path to escape from the suffering. What is the reason for that? We have the craving for that suffering. We have the desire in our depth for that suffering. That is why we have to, yes, we have to follow our special path to break that ignorance attaching with that suffering. This is the Dhamma for wise. Understand? So, in the understanding of this Four Noble Truths, in the first step of the wisdom, Supreme Buddha's Dhamma, the stream enterer, the first step. In this stream enterer step, Supreme Buddha explains, one can understand the Four Noble Truths. Okay, in this case, especially the five aggregates of clinging, one should understand in four ways to achieve the step of stream entering. Is it clear? To enter to the stream enterer position, he has to understand the five aggregates of clinging in how many ways? In five ways. The first one is, he has to understand the origination of the five aggregates. Understand? The second one is the cessation of the five aggregates. The third one is gratification of the five aggregates. The fourth one is drawback or danger of the five aggregates. The fifth one is the escape from the five aggregates. This is in the Sotapanna Sutta in Samyutta Nikaya third part. Is it clear? Okay. What are those to achieve the Srimantara in this very life? These four ways, in these four ways we have to understand the suffering. That means the five aggregates of things. What are those? The first one is origination of the five aggregates of things. Second one, cessation of the five aggregates of things. Third one, gratification of the five aggregates of clinging. Next one, danger of the five aggregates of clinging. Next one, escape of the five aggregates of clinging. Understanding in these five ways of the five aggregates of clinging, he has the opportunity to come to the extreme internal position in this very life. Coming to that position, he has the opportunity to escape from the hell, escape from the animal's world, escape from the world and over the bad destination. Because understanding of this five aggregates of clinging in this way, his wisdom is in a high position. That is why his next birth will be in the bad destination. In maximum seven lives, he will understand the four noble truths and attaining the ultimate deliverance, Nibbana is the ultimate deliverance. So now can you understand those things? The first one is origination of the five aggregates means we have to understand what are the five aggregates? The form aggregates of clinging, the feeling aggregates of clinging, the perception aggregates of clinging, the formation aggregates of clinging, the consciousness aggregates of clinging. So the origination of the clinging, origination of the five aggregates of clinging means we have to understand the origination of the four. Is it clear? So what is the origination of the four? There is a sutta in Samyutta Nikaya third part, Samadhi Bhavana. In that sutta, there is a way to understand the origination of the form. Keep in mind this very clearly, listen carefully. Origination of the form means the origination of the suffering. The same. Understand? Why is that? The form is the suffering. The five aggregates are the suffering in brief. So the form is the suffering. The origination of the form is what? The origination of the suffering. Understand? What is the origination of suffering? What is the origination of suffering? The dependent arising. The arising of the dependent arising. Is it clear? Origination of suffering is the dependent arising there. So in this way, in that Samadhibhavana Sutta, Supreme Buddha explains the origination of the form. This is the origination of the form in the dependent arising. If one delights the form, delights with the form, Oh, welcome the form. Appreciate the form. And he grasps with the form. Can you remember that? What is the Pali word? Yes. What is the Pali word? Abhinandati. Ajyotaya tittati. I can remember that you learnt it very well. That is the way of the origination of the form. If one delights the form, delights in the form, welcome the form, appreciate the form, and grasp the form with heart, the reason is, Supreme Buddha explains, the joy or the delight arises. Understand? Yes, yes, because of the appreciation of the form, what is the result? The desire arises. Desire arises. Pajyati nandi. Desire arises. Because of this desire, now can't we understand this, the nature, this condition in our own life? That is called understanding the origination of the form. If we can try to understand this situation in our own life, that's the meaning. We are trying to understand in the arising of the origination of the form. That's the meaning. We are trying to achieve the step of the stream enter position. So we have to understand this in our own life. So when we appreciate and when we relax and when we have the desire of the with the form, when we welcome the form, but the result, desire arises. Yarupe nandi. If there is a desire to the form, then what is the meaning of form? Rupa. Rupati di rupa. The nature of the is the distraction. That's the meaning of the form. So, what is the meaning of the form is, Supreme Buddha explains, the form is the four elements. Is it clear? The earth element, water element, fire element, air element. Those are the form. So, what is, so, to what that desire is in our heart? To that four elements. We have the desire for that four elements. For the earth element, for the water element, for the fire element, and for the air element. We have the desire. Now can you understand step by step what is the condition of, what is the nature of the ignorance? All those are things, not ourselves. There is a self there. But we have the desire to achieve those things. Oh, this is mine. This I am. This is myself. That's the ignorance. So, when the arising of the desire, Supreme Buddha explains, clinging is there. Yarope nandi tad upadana, tat upadana. Yarope nandi tad upadana. When there is the desire for that form, for the elements, for the form, the clinging is there. Independence of clinging, the volitional formation arises. Independence of volitional formation, what is there? Bhavapachya jata, the birth arises. Independence of birth, aging and death arises. This is the origination of the form. Now can you understand the meaning? Origination of the form is the same meaning to the origination of the suffering. In Samadhi Bhavana Sutta. In this way, you have the opportunity to understand the other over the 5 experience. Understand? That is the first one. So this is simple thing, that if we okay, let's suppose like this. If you see a beautiful thing from our eyes, let's suppose a cake. So what is there? The earth element, the water element, the fire element and air. So then form. But we are in the cell, inside the cell. We are covered with the ignorance. Covering with that ignorance, we haven't the ability to perceive that cave as it is. Okay? So what thing we are doing? We appreciate that cave. Oh, very beautiful. Oh, very sweet. Yeah? Abhinandati, Abhivadati, Ajvasayati. That's the meaning of delight, desire, appreciate, and all the things is there. All things are there. So, when we are appreciating that cake, what is the result? The desire arises for that cake. That is why we are eager to taste that cake. Okay? Okay, now the desire is there, desire arises. And with that desire, the independence of that desire, what is the next step? So, as Supreme Buddha has explained, Yarope Nandi, if there is the desire for that cake, understand, Yarope Nandi Sadhu Upadana, the craving is there. Upadana. Upadana Bhatya? Bhav. Being in that craving, we think and we talk about that cave and we use our body. That's the bhava, volitional formation. Upadana paccha bhava. What's the meaning of the volitional formation? The action with body, speech and mind. That's the bhava, that's the volitional formation. Understand? What is the meaning of bhava? The volitional formation arising with the body, speech and mind. Acting of the result of the using our volition. Chetana bhikkhave kammam vadam. Chetayitta kammam karoti kaya vataya manasaya. So, using our formation, that the thoughts, using our thoughts, then we think again and again, we talk about it, and we use our body. What is there? Bhava. Volitional formation. Now can you understand? Now the desire is there for that cake, and the independence of the desire, the clinging is there, and independence of clinging, the volitional formation arises. Independence of volitional formation, bhavapachya, jati, the birth arises. Independence of birth, aging and death, the cycle of birth and death, all is long journey suffering. That is the situation which happened in our past life. That is why birth is here. Now in this life, we are doing the same thing now. So, yes? Yes, we can assume. And we can guess the result. What is the result? Another birth. Understanding this is the core, the understanding, the origination of the form. Is it clear? Okay. Rupam abhinandati abhivadati ajvasaya kichati upajyati nandi. Yarupe nandi tadupadana. तस्य उपादान पच्या भव भव पच्या जाति जाति पच्या जरा मरण शोक परिदेव दुख दोमन उपायता एमेतस केवलस्य दुख खंदस समुदेवोति अयम रूपस्य समुदेव दिस इज द ओरिजिनेशन ऑफ द फॉर्म. Then, what is the second noise? The cessation of the form. All these things you have to understand in our own life. The cessation of the form meaning, if we have the desire for the form, if we don't delight, appreciate the form, anabhinandato, anabhivadato, anajyosaya chittato. If you don't appreciate the form, if you don't delight within the form, and if you don't welcome the form, oh, this is sweet, very beautiful. If you don't welcome like this, the result is what? Yarope nandi sa nirujjati. In the earlier position, upajjati nandi. Now what is here? Yarope nandi sa nirujjati. If there is a desire, the desire ceases. Understand? Nandi nirodha, upadana nirodha. Independence of the with the cessation of the desire, the clinging ceases. With the cessation of clinging, what? The volitional formation ceases. Upada nirodha bhava nirodha. Yeah, with the cessation of the volitional formation, the birth ceases. Bhava nirodha jati nirodha. With the cessation of the birth, the whole mass of suffering ceases. Understand? This is the cessation of the form. Understand? Okay. What is third knowledge? We have to deal with. The gratification of the form. Understand? Can you remember? The gratification of the form, that's meaning. Yam rupam paticca upajjati sukham somanattam ayam rupas assadu. Gratification means assadu. Aswadu.
The pleasure.
What?
The pleasure.
Pleasure. The, actually it is not the means pleasure. The gratification means the pleasure and the joy for the pleasure and the joy arise with the form, arise out of the form, arise because of the form. Can you understand? What is the meaning of the gratification? The pleasure and the joy arise because of the form. That's the gratification. When we see a form, what is there? There is a gratification in that form. What is the gratification? Yes, because of that form, a pleasure is in our mind. A pleasure arises in our mind. A joy arises in our mind. That is the gratification. And you have to understand this. When we see a form, if there is a joy, if there is a appreciable condition in that form, we have to understand what? Oh, this is the gratification of the form as Supreme Buddha explains. This is the knowledge. Understand? The second one is the drawback of the form, the danger of the form. What's the danger of the form? Yes? Yes, means it yam rupa anicca dukkha viparinama dhamma ayam rupa sa adi. Yes, in that same form, is subject, it is impermanent, sorrow and subject to change. That is the fourth knowledge, the danger of the form. Understand? The fifth knowledge, the last knowledge we have to develop in this very life to achieve the instrumental position, but escape from the form. But the escape of the form. Understanding the real situation. Now he has the knowledge that the origination of the form, and with the origination of the form, he has the knowledge that this origination of the form is the origination of the whole mass of the suffering. So understanding this and following our path to escape from the suffering, the next knowledge, escape from the suffering, is we have to abandon the desire for the form. That's called the escape of the suffering. Chandraga Vinaya, Chandraga Pahan. Understand? Nisarana. Those are the four knowledge. Now, if we can develop, if we can understand the five aggregates of clinging in this way, there's a great opportunity to understand our life. And all things are like this. Now the four aggregates of clinging, and we have to understand the other one, you see, the feeling, the origination of the feeling. Same. Now can you apply it? The origination of feeling is also same. When we appreciate, when we welcome the feeling, the desire arises. Same way. So how many feelings are there? Yes, three feelings arises from the six bases. That means the feeling from, yes, out of the contact of the eye and the contact of the ear, nose and tongue and body and mind. All these, in this all the six feelings, we have to understand that situation. Origination and the cessation, gratification, danger, escape. And the next one is perception, aggregates of feeling. How many perceptions are there? Six perceptions are there. What are those? The perception of forms, rupa sanya. The perception of sounds, sadda sanya. The perception of odor, the gandha sanya. The perception of taste or flavor, rasa sanya. The perception of tangible, that means potabha sanya. The perception of mind objects, dhamma sanya. Those are the six perceptions. So we have to understand origination, cessation, gratification, danger, escape of that perception. Now this is a natural thing. That means, let's suppose like this. Now, when we perceive the world, when we perceive those six perceptions, that means form and sounds and other things. Okay, let's remind like, let's suppose like this. The perception of our, now can you remember the early days of our life, our own life? The school time and other associate friends, you know, those are the all the things, that means form perception and the sound perception were there in our early life, in earlier age. But now what is the reason? It's like a dream, no? It's like a dream. But in that time, in that occasion, we enjoy with those things. That's the gratification of the perception. The gratification of the perceived things. But now, what the condition? All things are like a dream. That's the danger of the perception. Impermanent, sorrow and subject change. So, in this moment is also the gratification is here. The things of the perceived thing. But the, what there? In those same perceptions, the danger is there. But without understanding the reality of the perception on those five ways, no one can understand the life. Again and again, the suffering is there. But if he can understand in the real way of the reality of the perception, in these five ways, what is there? The suffering will not be him or her. Why is that? Knowledge is there. This is the nature of the perception. Now, the formations. How many formations are there? Six formations. What are those? The formation of eye, rupa sanchetana. The formation of sounds. That means sabda sanchetana. The formation of yes. Odors, that means gandha sanchetana. The formation of flavor, rasa sanchetana. The formation of tangible, potabha sanchetana. Next one, dhamma sanchetana. So understand, try to understand, we must try to understand in that five ways the real condition, the real nature of the six formations. And how many sensations are there? Six consciousness, eye consciousness, ear consciousness, nose consciousness, tongue consciousness, next one, body consciousness, mind consciousness. So, in the case of the understanding these five aggregates of clinging, it's not easy, but we can use the simile. Supreme Buddha has teached. What is the simile for the form? In the Supreme Buddha's Dhamma. The simile for the form is like a lump of form. What is the nature of the lump of form? Yes, the void and empty and without a substance. That's the meaning of the, that's the real nature of the form. This form is like that, Supreme Buddha. So we have to develop the wisdom to see as it is. And what is the simile for the feeling? It's like a bubble. Feelings, bubbles. But the, when it's raining, the water drops are falling much water, and what the nature? Yes, appearing and disappearing. This moment. That's the same way the feelings like pleasant, unpleasant, and made unpleasant, non-pleasant, always changing. But we have to understand this. We have to understand this changing. We have to control this nature. But because of that ignorance, what is the thing we are doing? We are trying to control those things. Thinking that this is mine, this I am, this is myself. That is the struggle there. That's the problem there. Because of this ignorance, again and again, we lose the chance to understand suffering. Okay. What is the simile for the perception? Mirage. What is the nature of the mirage? Shimmering the mirage, but when you close it, there is the light. The form is like that. The sound is like that. Supreme Being is there. We have to develop the wisdom. And what's the simile for the volitional formation? Banana tree trunk. Void and empty and without substance. But we think there is a, yes, there is a artwork there. We have to understand. And what is the simile for the consciousness? Like a magician in a crossroads. Magic. So where does live this magician? Inside the eye. Why? The eye consciousness is there. So always there is a magician with us. In our own eye, the magician is there. Magician is in our ear, not far away, but very near. Magician is in the nose, magician in the, it's in the tongue, it's in the body, it's in the mind. So always when we perceive the world from our eye, what is there? What is there? The magical illusion is there. That is why it's hard to understand the suffering, escape from the suffering. But for the wise, now the chance is there from the. But think about now, this, all the things we know from what? From the Supreme Buddha, Dhamma. Now can you guess the wisdom of our teacher? Can't even think. We are very, very lucky person in this whole world. So understanding, now can you understand the contact between the combination between the five aggregates and the dependent arising? In the case of the dependent arising, the five aggregates always arise. Understand? So if one can understand the five aggregates in that high way, what is the result? He has the opportunity to come to the step of the extreme entry. That's the thing. You can take more details from that sutta, Sotapanna Sutta, Sanyutta Nikaya, third part. So, if you have any questions, you can ask. But I think there might be any questions. But there is another thing. I explained this in the beginning of the lecture because there is an incident there that Supreme Buddha explains. Now, is it clear about that explanation? Five aggregates means that our own life. It's another name for our own life, five aggregates. It's not a far away thing, or it's not an outer world, or it's not an external thing. It's the name for our life. So, the meaning of the understanding the five aggregates of thinking is what? Understanding our own life. That is why open icon. Open icon. Supreme Buddha explains, if there is some fear or if there is some trouble, whatever it is, all the fears and all the troubles arise because of the fool, not because of the wise man. Is it clear? What is it? All the fear All the troubles arise because of the fool, not because of the wise. Then Supreme Buddha teaches, so tasmat ye bhikkhave, so bhikkhave, so bhikkhu, evam sikkhitabha. You should train like this. Pandita Bharisam. We should be wise. Supreme Buddha advised to us in what way? You should be wise. Evalingo Vikarisi Kitabha. In this way, you should train. Then, Venerable Ananda Bhikkhu asked from the question from the great teacher, what is the way to develop the wisdom, and how can Bhikkhu be a wise? What's the way to achieve that wisdom? That's the question. In that point, the great teacher explains, Bhikkhu dhātu kusalocha hoti. The Bhikkhu should be, the Bhikkhu skilled in the elements, dhātu kusala. Is it clear? Skilled in elements. Next one, āyatana kusalocha hoti. This is the way to develop the wisdom. Ayatana kusalocha hoti means the Bhikkhu is skilled in the basis.
You should have thorough knowledge.
Yes. There should be a good knowledge. Skilled. Next one, paticca samuppada kusalocha hoti. That's meaning Bhikkhu is skilled. Dependent arising. Next one. Now the about the dependent arising we talk now. And next one. Tana thana kusalocha hoti. It is a new thing, no? Have you heard ever before?
That's the one Lord Buddha has known it. Tana thana.
No. No, this knowledge is also with the stream enter also. Thana thana kusalocha hoti. That meaning is, should be developed knowledge that the things about the, it is possible, these things are possible and these things are impossible. The knowledge of the possibility and impossibility. Thana thana kusalocha. Have you heard ever before? No. So the paticchasamuppada kusala and other things you know already, but the other things actually dhatu kusala and ayatana kusala you have to learn later. But now I like to teach you this very briefly. This thana thana kusala. You have to develop it. Thana thana kusala means this. Kittāvatāpana bhante thānātāna kusalo bhikkhoti alam vachanāyāti. Our great teacher Supreme Buddha explains what is the meaning of the knowledge about the possibility and the impossibility. Understand? What is the meaning of that? The first one. This is the knowledge we have to gain in this field. A stream enterer, it is impossible. It's impossible that a stream enterer treats any formation as per Can you understand? This is the knowledge. But the knowledge? Stream enter and stream enter. No, it is impossible that stream enter create formation as permanent. But an ordinary person, it is possible that an ordinary person treats the formation as permanent. This is the first knowledge. Stream enter means the soda pan. Here, there is the word yan ditti sampanna. Ditti sampanna means soda pan. Stream enter. Can you understand the first knowledge? The second one is, it is impossible that a stream enterer create the formation as pleasure. It is impossible. Pleasure, the formation means all the conditioned things. Conditioned things. Subject to changing. Those things. And there is arising, there is a passing away, and there is a remaining between the arising and the passing away. Upada panyayati, vayo panyayati, citta sanyatattam panyayati. This is the nature of the conditioned things, all the conditioned things. But stream enterer, it is impossible that stream enterer create this formation as pleasure. This is second. But it is possible that an ordinary person feels the formation as pleasure. Is it clear? Third one. It is impossible a stream enterer creates the self, the formation as self. But it is possible an ordinary person creates the formations as self. This knowledge is also, Supreme Buddha explained, this knowledge also develop in our life. We have to know about these things. We have to develop a knowledge about these things. So these are the things. Understand? Next one. It is impossible a stream enterer take his mother's life. That means killing the mother. It's impossible. With whom? With only the stream enter. This is the knowledge of the Supreme Buddha, and we have to gain that knowledge. And but it is possible an ordinary person kill his mother. This is the danger of the ordinary person. Ordinary life. And next one, it is impossible stream enterer kill his father. Impossible. It is possible the killing of the father with the ordinary person. And next one, it is impossible stream enterer kill an arahant. But it is possible an ordinary person will kill an arahant. Is it clear? Next one. It is impossible a stream enterer with the hatred mind the injuring to the Supreme Buddha. That means shed the blood of the Supreme Buddha's body. It's impossible with stream enterer. But it is possible an ordinary person shed the blood of the blood of the Supreme Buddha's body. All these are very the dangerous situation in one's life. If one is dealing with those things, next life is definitely he has suffer in the hell. For a year, couple. Now it's okay. Next one is, it is impossible stream enter divide the sangha. Skishing. Skishing, no? Yes. Skishing of sangha. But it is possible with the ordinary person. This is skishing of sangha. Is it clear? Next one. It is impossible stream enterer will stream enterer ask for the liberation from another teacher about his life. Why that? In this association of the Supreme Buddha, already the person, yes, can understand the life. That is why he never goes to any teacher to ask about his life. This is a natural truth. This is a truth about but with only the stream enterer of life. Is it clear? But an ordinary person, it is possible an ordinary person will ask for the other about his life, about the liberation of the suffering and the things, escaping all the suffering. It is impossible to stream enterer of life. Next one. In same, in one world system, it is impossible the true accomplished and fully enlightened arising. It is impossible arising of the arahant and accomplished and fully enlightened one. Is it clear? In one world system, it is impossible. Next one. Is it clear? In one world system, it is impossible to accomplish and enlightened one arising. Yes. No, no, no. The meaning is this: in one world system, at one, it is impossible of the arising of two Buddhas. Is it clear? Okay. Next one.
Concurrently, they don't exist.
Yes. And next one is this is atthanamita. Anyway, it's impossible. Next one. It is impossible in one world system. The wheel turning monarch, the rising of the wheel turning monarch, two wheel turning monarchs, Chakravarti Raju. It is impossible in one world system, two existence of the wheel turning monarch. Is it clear? Next one. It is impossible that a woman is born as a wheel turning monarch. This is impossible. These are not the creation of the Supreme Buddha. These are the conditions, the natural conditions.
Queen who can,
yes, this is the knowledge of the Supreme Buddha. So develop the confidence about the Supreme Buddha. No one in this world system knows about these things. And it is impossible in this world a woman is born as the god of Sakra Devi. This is impossible. But it is possible a man is born as a wheel turning monarch. It is possible a man is born as a god of Sankara. Is it clear? These are those knowledge. Thana. What is that word?
Thana
kusalo bhikkhu. Thana kusalo. Kusalo means skill. It's skill in possible and impossible things. Next one, it is impossible a woman is born as the man, but it is possible a man is born as a man. These are the conditions.
You don't have to be scared of them.
And the next one, it is impossible in this world system a woman is born as a Brahmana, a Mahabrahmana. Yes. And it is possible a man is born as a Brahmana. Is it clear? Next one. It is impossible with the bad conducting of the body, bad conducting of the mind, bad conducting of the speech, the good result is impossible. But it is possible the bad results, the bad fruit with the bad conducts of body and speech and mind. This is also knowledge we have to give. And with the that's ill conducted, that with the well conducted of the body, speech and mind, it's possible the good results, good fruit. That's also knowledge. Next one, with the practicing of the good bodily conduct, bodily actions and verbal actions and mental actions, the bad destination is impossible. This is the knowledge of the spirit. And with the well-conducted of the body, mind and speech, the good, the happy destination is possible. These are the knowledge we have to, and I explain those things. So now, is it clear? What is the meaning of the thana thana kusala? Is it clear? Thana thana kusala means we have to give, we should have what do you call it? A knowledge should be with us, like these things. That's the meaning thana thana kusala. Is it clear? Okay. Now, what's your aspiration? So, understanding about this dependent arising with the five aggregates of thinking, we can develop that the skills. That all the details are included in the Bahudhātaka Sutta, the Majjhima third part. Now you, I think you must have so many knowledge about those things. And if you have any questions, you can ask. Or if you have any questions, you can come to the end. Can you understand what I am saying?
Very much.
Because I try, but I don't know. I am familiar with these things. But the thing is, actually, I have the, for some certain the Pali knowledge. It is enough for me. The only thing is, I want to read these suttas and to develop my wise consideration, but you have to do. Actually, it is enough the Pali, and Pali is the great language, no? It is in all the languages.
It is the greatest language.
No other all languages, there are the words to blame others, to insult others. In English and all the languages, but in Pali language, no words. No bad words to insult and to blame others. What is the reason for that?
Because the word
Yes, this is the language of the great teacher, Supreme Being.
That was not a spoken language in India at that time.
No, at that time, this is the language. Supreme Buddha. Which? Same for this. Yes, same is. There are some, but for some certain, same. This is the Supreme Buddha's own language. Why? Within 3 months of the passing away, Supreme Buddha, is it possible to change the language of the Supreme Buddha? By Yarama? No, never. So this is the mother language. So as possible as we can, one by one, step by step, word by word, you must try to learn those things. So that's why I say that it is enough to Pali knowledge for me. But let's try to do all the things.